Hello there, good day people, and welcome to my latest tutorial. On today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a file that nobody can delete it, and we're going to put password there, and this file is going to be resistant to viruses. So what we're going to do is this. This is a text file, or a note file that I've written a program or certain codes on it that works on same with that command prompt. Now we're going to see this is kind of cumbersome and light show. I'm just going to explain certain functions. So now if we see echo means that we want to give out an information. CLS means to clean the program, mean that to clear the stuff. And now echo off means that we want to send echo. We don't want that anytime that we send echo, it makes a statement echo off, and which statement we want to send. So we use this colors. It means we want to define a color. Now coming down here, let me show you where our password is found. So the other thing that you can modify. Coming here, if not percentage pass. Now go, this is our password here, LIOVVE. So now go to fill. Now should in case this password is joined together with go to discover that every person that opens this file, with no matter the letter or the words that enter, will open this file even if it's not the password, but we're going to separate it to follow the norm. So after, if the person enter wrong password, this is what happens. Instead, we will generate a file which happens to be a metrics program and we'll go to fail. So quickly, assuming you already have this code, so if you can't see it very well after to copy it, you can just send me a message on my video comment, and I will resend this code manually. So we're going to go to file, we're going to go to save as. Now save as document.com.bat. Now point bat is a batch file, and we're going to open all type of files. So we're going to save. Immediately this, we're going to discover that a batch file has been created. So this is a new text document, but happens to be a Windows batch file. So we're going to delete this man because we don't need him anymore. So we're going to open this, and you're going to see what. Now they say protected, created successfully. Now press any key. Now it's telling you that this file has been created for the first time. It opens without accessing your password. Now next, let's say we want to close this file. So here we have O, which means we, and N, which means none. So you can arrange yours. Now assuming that somebody that has never seen this program does not know what you do. So what do we, for example, if you enter a letter like H, so what happens is this, it will explain to him, please choose either O for we or N for long. This for more information, content engineer outboard, that happens to be me. So you can just display this. So we're going to go out and we're going to say okay, we want to close this file, which is we. Now it say it's going to display this folder is locked using a command that we write post. So we want to see what it displays. We want to open this file, and now the when we want to open this file, if you enter a right password, what happens? Hello, so this is going to tell us folder unlocked successfully, and we're going to see the folder here. So we open this folder, and this folder is empty at first sight, so we're going to put something inside this folder so that we can lock it. So I'm just going to copy this, let's say I'm going to copy word 2016, and I'm going to put it inside. So let's say no matter, you can put your music, anything you can put, even other folders. We're going to paste this, and we're going to have our what inside. So we're going to go out, and now assuming I want to lock this folder that I already have stuff inside, so it's weak. I want to lock this folder, it's going to folder lock. Now if somebody tries to open this folder without having your password, what actually happens? If you enter a password like me and I hit enter, now it's going to discover that immediately it's going to hit enter, this program is going to change and becomes a batch, it becomes a random or metrics. So it displays number in a random manner and showing you red. So that's all the person will understand. So the person is just obliged to off this, so it does not know your password now. But there's another disadvantage with this. This is not the best method to prevent people from having access to your file, because immediately somebody can click, right click and edit, so go and change your password. So to stop this, we are going to use winrar. So winrar is a software that is free in the internet, and yes, if you have a connection, let's say for 100 mega, you can download it, because with the winrar that I have here, I think is 2.4 mega. That's it, 2.4 megabyte that we can see. So this is how it looks like. So you just need to download it. but we are not going to download it because I already have. So assuming you downloaded it and you install, just click WinRAR download for PC or the depending on your system that you're using. So you're going to, instead of opening this, we're going to right click on this. So right click on this, and we're going to go to Ajouter and Archive. Now discover the, what you're going to do now is to give you access that nobody can know the password and nobody can change it. So we're going to click this and we want to define the mode pass. So just look at it, it's the same for English. So our mode password, we're going to click this shift for the long fichier. Now we're going to put 1 2 3 4, sorry, click 1 2 3 4 as our password, hit enter, and we're going to say okay. Now it's immediately going to create us a WinRAR archive. Now if you click on this to open this archive, what happens there is going to ask a password. Now in using this method, nobody can know your password. So you just enter 1 2 3 4 and okay, we are in. So just click here and the same procedure over, you just enter your password and you have access to your file. You say okay, this file is created, you go out. Now open this and you see your file protected and you see your word inside that you can open. So this is how we protect a file using a password. And now with WinRAR, we discovered that no virus can attack such a file in WinRAR. It's very hard to see virus that can attack this, and now we can protect this file using our password. So we discovered that. That is amazing. So thank you and see you next week for my latest tutorial. Until then, bye.